Here we are, 2020, a year jam-packed with some fantastic game titles, and the event that occurs less than twice in a decade.
Occurs twice in a year.
I can't say it. The new generation of consoles and games. And in this video, we will visit those games and sprinkle them with my opinions. We will praise some and piss on others, but at the end of it all, you will be enlightened. All those game titles are in the order of their release dates. First in line, Warcraft 3 Reforged. It's a real-time strategy game from 2003. This is promised to be released from its shackles in 28th of January 2020. Although it's a bit funny that this game was supposed to be released in December last year. But to be honest, make it better, make it right. I don't want to eat a half-baked muffin, thank you. Now I know that this title is on PC only, but I have been experimenting with PC games as well. I played it a little since my PC at that time was as powerful as a modern-day toaster. I skipped most of it and played on my trusty old PS2. Sadly, console platforms have skipped most good RTS games and everything worth playing is on PC, at least in that genre. But now I can finally play this remastered, reforged and graphically enhanced masterpiece in less than a month. Do you remember Warcraft 2, Tides of Darkness, also known as Dark Saga? I loved it, I just loved it. And see, it played on a console. Ridiculous! PC exclusives. You can just suck it. Anyways, moving on. Next in the line, Two Point Hospital, February 25th, coming to PS4, Xbox One and Switch. Ah, oh, another good one. Straight from 1997, Theme Hospital was awesome. Funny diseases and even funnier cures. Managing your staff and financials, improving your customer service, and expanding your hospital to gain maximum revenue, opening new areas with more complex strategies and new diseases and ha! 25th of February. We are supposed to get a new version. Not a remake, but kinda part 2 of this game. Updated graphics, even weirder diseases I have heard, but the skeleton and the backbone will still be the original game from 1997, no pun intended. I hope there will be even more weirder places to build hospitals, maybe even space. Imagination running wild as a gazelle in Africa or a threatened rhinoceros. Next in line, Skull and Bones. Yes, I think this has to be one of the best and most anticipated games of my list, for me at least. It was supposed to come out last year, but it was pushed to March 2020. So why this game? Basically, the answer is simple. I will answer it with a question. What was the best part of Assassin's Creed Black Flag? Most, including me, would say the best parts of this game were the sea battles and exploration. The closest thing to this kind of freedom should have been Sea of Thieves, released by Microsoft. But they screwed it up big time in 2018. You might remember this game kind of flopped completely due to the lack of endgame content and the boring gameplay mechanics. Also, the sea was empty, and Kraken only had tentacles visible with nothing else underneath the water's surface. Ridiculous. Well, we might now have something on the horizon we have been waiting for. Skull and Bones might be the knight in shiny armor, the cherry on your ice cream, the bee's knees, the ying to your yang, the glaze on your donut. I really hope that they will make it work and it's anything similar to Assassin's Creed. If it is, you can just take my wallet. Take my wallet, vast seas to explore, beautiful graphics. I mean, the trailer itself, although pre-rendered, it looks better than anything I have seen on a console, ever, honestly. And have you noticed how the last games of each console in the end of their generation have always had the best graphics and the highest fidelity? It's just how it is. The transitional generation. These games probably will give you a good hint at the gorgeousness of the next generation. And I'm eagerly waiting, Skull and Bones. Please, make it good. Next in line, Resident Evil 3 Remake. promised to be released in April 3rd, and I have pre-ordered this game already, because I know exactly what this game is going to be. I have completed the original at least 10 times, even on hard difficulty, just because I wanted to get the Desert Eagle and all the costumes. I hope that the Mercenary mode is still included with this remake, not to be bought separately. But I'm a bit hesitant to see how this new Jill face blends with the franchise. And also, it's weird that Nemesis now has a nose. What I love is that you can visit the police station again, but this time you have the whole city to explore. Hidden lockers filled with ammunition as you backtrack. More jump scares in this game, so don't forget to wear your diapers. And new and funny puzzles I hope they add to this remake as well, like checking the drawer in Star's office for 50 times straight to get the surprise. Stuff like that. With amped graphics, this game would be a treat to experience once again. Next in line, Cyberpunk 2077. I think this title is one of the most anticipated titles of this year. I don't even know a person who has not heard about it. Futuristic first-person RPG from CD Projekt Red, a company known and loved for Witcher series, and the fairness of their monetization policies. A company who truly cares about the player. I honestly don't know anyone else who has had the same kind of passion and respect for gamers as them. Bethesda, forget about it. Trust is gone. Activision lost their soul a bit less than a decade ago. EA never even had a soul. And I'm not talking about indie publishers. I'm talking about AAA first-class experience games that have seen hundreds of people working on it for years and years upon years. So, CD Projekt Red, just take my money. I will get the collector's edition for sure. I will even pre-order it, if it's possible, because Estonian stores only order using the number of pre-orders. Rarely are there any collector's editions on the shelf here. And if there are, they're probably shitty games or overpriced dirt cobblers. So, Cyberpunk 2077, amazing cast, exceptional graphics, and hopefully a vast world to explore. A lot of shooting, cybernetically enhanced characters, and probably the best narrative of 2020. I can't wait, I truly can't. Next in line, Dying Light 2. At the Microsoft E3 2019 conference, we learned that Dying Light will be released in spring 2020, which can mean that it can be anywhere between March and May. Dying Light 2 is a survivor horror action role-playing game. This will be the most zombie-filled experience in 2020, trust me. More parkour, bigger city, well, three times as big as the previous game. Close quarter combats with wooden blanks and iron pipes, and access straight to the jugular. Fun and bloody times await us as we will get and enjoy this release. Next in line, The Last of Us Part 2. Promised to be released in May 29th. And to be honest, the next thing I'm going to say might offend you, but it's only my opinion, so please forgive me. For me, this game is the least anticipated game in my list. And to be honest, I'm even waiting to experience measles again more than this game. Okay, the last statement might have been too much, but I really didn't even get the first episode that much. For me, it was overhyped, just as this one. It was a linear storytelling game with very few or no options at all, meaning that yes, it's a good game with good story, but everything is too scripted, hand-holdy. Oh, go there, put the ladder in there, yeah, put the ladder in there, climb up from there, toss a glass there, yeah, scary, walk through this shit and get an emotional cutscene. And I'm sure that this game will be exactly the same. Yes, but I will buy it. I will play it and I will make a review. And I hope that this game surprises me. That is why I keep my emotions and optimism at bay. Do you remember Beyond Two Souls? Now this game was interesting. Yet I hear no one ever mentioning it. If Last of Us was a masterpiece, then Beyond Two Souls was the father and the mother. In this game, you had a wonderful cast, Willem Dafoe and Ellen Page. And by the way, Hans Zimmer composed the music for it. What else do you want? Next, please! Age of Empires 4. likely to be released in 2020, but a bit later, so I am not sure that this game even gets to us in 2020. But I added it anyway, since I truly loved the previous releases. I get some nostalgic goosebumps as I remember these times. Boy, was I stupid and ignorant, but damn, the games were good. Right now, we have only had sneak peeks of this release, kind of a small amount of gameplay and so on, but I really hope that they will get it out this year. And finally, this one is not a game, but the anticipation level is through the roof nevertheless. PlayStation 5 and Xbox X Series. Wow, the new age starts now. Future will be in our hands in less than 10 months. Following weeks will bring us new news and many debates that whose tallywhacker is bigger, Microsoft's or Sony's. The funny thing is that Xbox fanboys usually scream the loudest. But, I'm sure that both of those consoles will be powerful and have made their technologies future-proof. We will find it out months leading to the release. I promise to cover some news. And of course, the most important of all, I will unbox one of those lucky consoles in my video as the day approaches. So, here it is, the most anticipated gaming list of 2020. I know that I left some good releases out, but this was a personal list. So please do leave a comment, what kind of games are you waiting for? I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like, smash that bell, and if you dare, subscribe as well. I'm Sillyllamaz, and thanks for watching. Till next time!